Dear students, let's enjoy a very interesting phenomena, that is a friction. Friction, we know this is the resistance to the motion and it always opposes the motion. Friction always apply in the opposite direction of a motion.
How friction changes?
On rough surface, friction will be more. If we will try to move a vehicle on a rough surface, we will feel difficulty. While moving, whenever we will apply brake, then easily the vehicle will comes in the rest. But on the smooth surface, if you will consider, vehicle will move faster. But on smooth surface, when we will apply brake, it will come on the rest easily. But on the slippery road, or we can say on the ice, when we are trying to move a vehicle, it is very difficult to move, but whenever we will apply brake, then it's difficult to make the vehicle stop. The opposing force that comes into play whenever an object tries to slide over another object is called friction. You see, friction always apply in the opposite direction. From one side we are applying pushing force, and in which direction we will apply the pushing force, in that direction only it will move. But friction will be always opposite to the pushing force or applied force.
What causes friction?
Friction occurs whenever two surfaces rub against each other. Friction is a force that always opposes motion. If we will see the surface of any object which is very smooth, if that smooth from microscope, when we will see that surface, we will see the irregularities or uneven surface due to the bumps, or we can say that bumps will look like a hill and valleys from the microscope. Whenever two smooth surface will come in the contact, these hills and valleys like surfaces will form the interlocking between each other when it will come in the contact. This only causes the friction and it will oppose the motion.
Factors on which friction depends. Number one is nature of the surface in contact, and second is how hard the surface are pressed with each other.
Nature of surface means if the nature is rough, then friction will be more. If the surface will be smooth, then friction will be less.
That means on the rough surface, when we will apply brake, then vehicle will stop easily. But on the icy or smooth surface, when we will apply brake, then it will slip due to the less friction.
Friction depends on the nature of the surface in contact with each other. In the case of rough surface or in the case of smooth surface, we will compare this. On the rough surface, when two surfaces will come in the contact, suppose tire of the vehicle or the shoe sole, then from the road and our shoes, or from the road and vehicle's tire, interlocking will be more. Due to the roughness, that friction will be more and there will be more difficulty while moving, and moment stops easily.
Friction depends on how hard the surface are pressed with each other. Now you will see the figure. More heavy pressed harder means if the object is heavy. In the case of heavy object, the surface are pressed harder with each other and the friction will be more. In this case, when the mass of object is more, then the friction will also more. In same way, when the mass of object is less, then it is lighter. Due to the less weight, it will press the surface lighter. So in this case, the friction will be less due to the lighter object, and the objects will move more easily.
On the icy surface, irregularities on the surface filled with water, and it makes the surface smooth and reduce the friction. That's why
we are not able to work properly and we will sleep easily. Due to the smooth surface, friction is less.